Good morning, students. In continuation to our previous video, we are going to discuss about terrorism and how terrorism is responsible for violation of human rights. So first we need to understand what is terrorism. Terrorism is basically is having following characteristics. First is violence. No doubt all of us know terrorism involve lots and lots of violence. Then there is a psychological impact or fear among the common masses. Acts of terrorism are devised to have an impact on large number of people. Terrorists generally attack the most important people or most important places or national symbols only to show that they are very powerful. Like for example, we all know about the attack on World Trade Center and the Pentagon in USA. These places are of national importance. One is the Trade Center where international financial activities take place, and another one is the defense headquarters of USA. So both of these places were attacked by the terrorists. Then the third one is they are committed for achievement of certain political goals. Obviously these activities, terrorist activities, have certain kinds of goals. All terrorist acts have a political purpose behind it. When activists believe that there is no other method to bring about the change that they want to bring out, they get involved in terrorism, right? And they do such activities because of which the government can consider their purpose, or they can fulfill their wish or desire. Then the last one is they target the non-combatants. It means terrorists intentionally select civilians who are not at all linked to any of the cause or any of the purpose. So they make them the target. Reason being selecting the civilians is that they want to instill fear in them. They want a message for the general public that we can create any kind of problem among the masses. They want to put pressure on government because they know government will be pressurized if they see that the general public, the civilians, are going to be affected. To fulfill their political objective, they know it is better to target the masses. Then how terrorism and human rights are interconnected? Obviously, because of terrorism, various human rights are being affected. Terrorism threatens security of human being as it takes many innocent lives. It threatens the dignity of human being because human beings are forced to live in such a situation, in such a such less dignified life. Because of the fear of terrorism, it creates an environment that destroys the freedom of people. Because of terrorist activities, various kinds of freedoms of individuals are affected, because in such disturbed areas, various civil liberties are taken away. It has a negative effect on establishment of rule of law. Any of the law will not be implementable in such scenario. It destroys the democratic basis of society by destabilizing the governments. Right, in the affected areas, the government use various kind of restrictions. So in that scenario, the democratic bases are obviously violated. It is also linked with various other organized crimes like drug trafficking, then money laundering, then trafficking in arms and ammunition, then illegal transfer of nuclear, chemical or biological material for any of the wrong purposes, then murders, extortions, kidnapping, assault, hostage taking and robbery. All these other crimes are associated with the terrorism. It has a negative impact on the economic and social development of state. Because of terrorist activities, various liberties are taken away and all the government focus transferred to the counter-terrorism measure. So in that scenario, obviously the economic and social development of that particular area is affected, as in case of Jammu and Kashmir. It endangers friendly relation and cooperation among states, the neighboring countries from where the terrorism is supported. Obviously, we cannot have a good relation with those countries. It threatens the territorial integrity and security of the state. No doubt about it. It has a greater impact on our integrity and security of our nation. It violates the purpose of principles of United Nations. United Nations want to establish peace throughout the international borders. And terrorism is not at all in line with these objectives. It is a threat to international peace and security, we all know. Now, what is the obligation of state in this scenario? The state has to ensure effective criminal justice and law enforcement system, so this kind of activities could not happen. Then another one is measure to deter the commission of offences, right? There should be certain measures, certain steps which should be taken by the government so as to stop these kind of offences or crimes. Then government should investigate violation wherever they occur, violation of the rights, violation of the rules, everything has to be supervised. Then government has to ensure that those suspected of criminal acts are prosecuted properly so that the information could be retrieved from them, and if they have committed the crime, they should be punished. To provide a victim with effective remedies, whomsoever has been affected because of these crimes or terrorist activities, they should be given immediate relief and remedies should be given to them, justice should be given to them, compensation should be provided to them by the government. Then necessary action should be taken by the government to prevent recurrences of the violation. Such activity should not repeat in future. This also should be ensured by the government by ensuring better defense mechanism. Then take preventive operational measures to protect individual those life is suspected to be at risk. If certain kind of information has been received that this place or this person or anything else who is at risk, who is who has to face the consequences of terrorist activities or terrorist activities or initiatives, then those areas, those people should be protected. In order to fulfill their obligation, state should have certain counter-terrorism measures. The objective of these measures is to prevent and discourage future terrorist attacks so that such activities could not happen in near future. And then another objective is to prosecute those that are responsible for carrying out such act so that we can trace out the links, the people who are behind these activities. Now, counter-terrorism measures are these. Number one is target hardening. Target hardening is the defense mechanism which is given to the prospective target which has been chosen by the terrorist. A strategy of strengthening the security of building or placing concrete barriers outside building to prevent terrorist attack, right? Then second is preemptive neutralization. It includes capturing, killing or disabling suspected terrorists. They have not committed the crime yet, but they are suspects. There is some information that these people are going to do certain mischievous activities. So before that, they have been captured or killed or they have been disabled so that they cannot mount an attack. Interrogation of known or suspected terrorists to obtain information so that we can have more information about their links and their backgrounds. Then intelligence and surveillance system has a greater role in counter-terrorism measure because these are the bodies which will provide the information about various kind of activities happening in and around so that preemptive neutralization can be done. Intelligence and surveillance systems are used to capture secretive information by use of various technology. For example, interception of communications which these terrorists do. Then decoding of secret messages which they use to communicate with themselves and tracing of persons. Then at various places where the situations become out of control, military intervention is also done. Sometimes military intervention is required to deal with terrorism in the country. Like in Jammu and Kashmir, we had military deployed. Government passed the order for same in if the situation becomes out of control and strict measures are required, as I said earlier. Right, then non-military interventions are also required. Human security issues lead to the option of non-military intervention because in various cases we have observed that military has used their special powers in a negative sense also. Measures are taken by government to ensure equal access to resources and sustainability for all people. Whomsoever are living in those areas, those disturbed areas, all of them also have certain rights which should be taken care of by the government. Such activities have a positive approach which empower the citizen and provide them freedom from fear. Obviously, if this kind of measures are taken by the government, the citizens can lead a fearless life that the government is there to take care of them. So, these kind of counter-terrorism measures are taken by the government. Next, we'll discuss in next video.